Good morning and welcome to lecture number 3 of engineering graphics, lettering, sheet layout, lines and dimensioning. My name is Professor Sachin Todkar. I'm assistant professor in mechanical engineering department, Navasahyadri. So we'll see engineering lettering. What types of lettering are, you can say, we can do in engineering. Single stroke and double stroke. Normally single stroke lettering is famous in all the sheets. So vertical and incline, there are two types of lettering in single stroke, but vertical has been in practice. Incline lettering we can do, but it is not in practice. Double stroke also, it is available vertical and incline, but we prefer single stroke vertical lettering. These are some words which we are going to see their strokes, etc., how they can be written. So you will see here 6x6 blocks, and in that we have to write I, L, T, F, E, H, V, A, W in this manner. So this will be a standardized lettering system in a vertical lettering system. O should be completely round. Q, C, G, these are totally rounded up kind of letterings. And this 8 is having standard, that is a small circle will be on upper side and larger circle will be on lower side. You can see B. Here there is small curvature and here it is a large curvature. So that we have to remember. 3, 2, 9, 6, 4, 7, 5, etc. All these letterings are standard lettering systems and we are going to adopt. Now these are inclined lettering system. We are not going to see indeed because this is not in practice in you can say in engineering right now. Okay, this is actual drawing sheet layout. So if you'll see the drawing sheet, we have to keep the distances of 20, 10, 10 and 10 mm from all the sides. Only left side is 20 mm, others are 10 mm. The title box will be 160 mm by 63 mm. And this total side is called as a drawing space. This is called as a drawing frame. Now we'll see in detail how the title boxes can be written. So you have to write here college name. Maybe normally it is printed here. In case of companies, the company name is printed here. Then you have to write your name, drawing title, sheet number, date, scale, section, roll number, check by. Okay. And all these the dimensions are to be kept in mind. So all the boxes are having 9 mm dimension. This is having 40 width, 40 and 80 width. So this is the standard title box. Now types of line we are going to use in actual practice here. So you can see a continuous thick line will have 0.5 mm thickness and it will be used for visible outlines. Continuous thin line is having 0.2 mm thickness. How we are going to vary the thicknesses with the help of the stroke, you can say, or the force on that stroke, we can manage the thicknesses. So for dimension lines, your thin line should be there having 0.2 mm thickness. So it should be very faint enough. Extension line should be faint enough. Projection lines, leader lines and hatching lines should be faint enough. With the help of stroke, you can manage these thicknesses. Dash medium thick. This is for hidden line. We have seen in isometric and orthographic views what is hidden line. The same thing we are going to use here 0.3 mm thickness dash medium thick line. Chained thin line will be represented for center line, line of symmetry and locus line. If you are drawing any circle or any symmetric part, then you have to draw this chain thin line and at the center of that particular object. Chain thin and thick ends only. So when we do the thickening of ends, 0.2 mm will be the basic line and 0.5 mm at the end. It will show the cutting plane, which is required to give you the detail of that particular view. So that cutting plane line will be chained thin and thick ends only. Chain thin double dash, it will have thickness of 0.2 mm. It will be representing outlines for adjacent parts, alternative and extreme positions of movable parts. Now in first year, it is not needed, but in mechanical engineering, you need the these type of lines should be known to you. Continuous thin width zigzag, this is shown for a long brake line. It will have a thickness of 0.2 mm. So if you have observed the previous slide also, only for visible outline, we are going to use continuous thick line of 0.5 mm. Everywhere there is 0.2, 0.3 mm thickness. So that has to be remembered. Now dimensioning. Some dimensioning techniques we are going to see here. So this is called as a unidirectional system. In unidirectional system, you can see the numbers are having only one direction, that is they are horizontally written. Okay, so this is a unidirectional system. The dimensions are placed so they can be read from bottom of the drawing sheet. So they have been written horizontally. The dimension lines are broken near the middle for inserting the dimension. This method is commonly used in mechanical drafting. But there is another drawing or dimensioning technique that is called as aligned system, in which we are going to use aligned dimensions. So it can be written, it can be read from bottom or the right side. The dimensions are placed so the horizontal dimensions can be read from the bottom and vertical dimensions can be read from the right side of the drawing sheet. This method is commonly used in architectural and structural drafting, that you have to remember. Now, this is called as parallel dimensioning. It consists of several dimensioning originating from one position. So it will be starting from one point and we are going to show the respective positions of all the parts. Or other method is chain dimensioning, in which dimensions are arranged in a single straight line and they will be relative to each other, relative to the original position. So here we'll write X, Y and Z. Okay, so these will be the chain dimensioning techniques. This one, this is called as extension line. So we have to extend any part to show the dimension. Then this is called as a dimension line and these are the arrowheads. We are going to see in details how the arrows are drawn. So if the width of arrow is W, the length should be 3 times W, that is to be remembered. So this has been preferred. This is not preferred. This type of dimensioning we are not going to prefer in the dimensioning technique. This is called as dimension value. So if there is any diameter, we write it as phi, 1 phi, that is 15. So this circle is having diameter of 15. This line is called as a leader line. This is arrowhead, this is dimension line, this is projection line. We have seen in previous slide also. Then this is a radius. Radius is to be shown from center to the arc. So we have drawn two center lines, and from that center point to R, we have written R30. So in case of radius is there, we have to write R. In case of diameter is there, we have to write phi. We'll see in detail the dimensioning of circle. You can see here, the center line is to be chain thin. Two center lines have been drawn, the diameter has been drawn, and there are two arrows which are showing the exact diameter of that particular circle at 45 degree incline, and diameter 15 has been written here. So here we can see it properly. Now this is linear dimensions. You can see here 40, 20, 50 are in linear dimensioning method. Dimensioning of circle, the same things have been elaborated here. If this is inclined, then you have to show the dimension line also at this parallel to that particular dimension. So these are dimension lines alignment have been shown here. If you want to give the dimension to the angle, you have to write in this manner, 25 degree or 20 degree, you have to write it. Now arrangement of dimensioning, we have seen just now, that is chain dimensioning and parallel dimensioning methods are there, and we can use combined dimensioning method also, depending on the space available. Methods of indicating dimensions. So this is called as align method, and this is called as unidirectional method. General rules for dimensioning, we'll see some dimensioning where if it is preferred or not preferred. You can see here, this dimension has been given inside the object. Inside the object will not prefer the dimensioning. This has been, you can say, preferable dimensioning system. That is, we have shown it in one straight line. So dimension figures are never preferred to be written within the object view. So that has to be remembered. Second rule, the object outline should not be used as extension line. We have to show the separate extension line here. This is not preferred, this is preferred, but we have to show the separate extension line, and we have to draw the dimension. This one, if you'll see, this slot is having very small width, and if I'll write here inside that particular of the slot position, then it is not preferred. So how it has been preferred? You can show like this, the dimensions arrows outside, and write the dimension inside, or you can show it outside that particular dimension. If the space of writing a dimension is too small to indicate dimension line, arrowheads and the dimension number, the dimensions may be mentioned externally with the help of continuing line. So this continuous line has been drawn outside, and we have shown it as the dimension equal to 5. Or we can show the arrows outside and dimension inside. Both are preferred. Now, here you can see this dimension and these dimensions are having some problems, like just like this extension line is cutting 1, 2, 3 dimensions. So the cutting of extension line to the dimension lines is not preferred. If single extension line is used for more number of dimensions starting from common place, then smaller dimension should be written inside, larger it's outside, and largest as totally outside. So this has been preferred. 10, 25, 45, 60 will be preferred. This will not be preferred because it is not aesthetically looking good, or it will create confusions for the engineer to, you can say, understand the things. Now you can see here, dimension is not preferred over dotted line. Dotted lines we have drawn for the hidden portion, so we cannot show it here where the dotted portion is not visible. But in this front view or in this top view, we can see here particular dimension properly, so we can draw it here. This is not preferred where the dimension is, the part is not visible. The dimension should be placed on the face that describes the feature most clearly. Now you can see here, this is a circle. These are dotted lines of the circle. The feature is visible here completely. A circle is completely visible. So I can draw it here and give the dimension of diameter. This is not preferred. Similarly, here you can see that this slotted part is shown here, but it is clearly visible in this view. In this view, it is not visible, so we are going to avoid it. So if the particular portion is visible in one view, then you can give the dimension at that particular position. Similarly, extension line should never be shortened. You cannot shorten the extension line. You have to completely show the extension lines. Do not repeat a dimension. It will only confuse the reader and could cause error in reading the drawing correctly. So same dimension should not be given in all three positions. We have to avoid the repetition of the dimension as possible. Okay, so these are some dimension rules. We will see some other part in next lecture. And till then, Sachin Tholkar is signing out. Thank you very much for listening this particular lecture.